I guess. So before, getting to space usually means holding your space bar for like 7 minutes or something, depending on the planet. And that's usually not a problem unless you go in and out of planets a lot. Then it can start to get tedious. Well, there's a new event on the event controller block called natural gravity change. And you can set it so that if the natural gravity is equal or less than 0g, then the block will just turn off your ship's upward thrusters. So now, you can just keep your upward thrusters on override, and then once the gravity reach zero, then the upward thrusters will just automatically turn off. Now you might say, isn't that gonna be expensive on fuel if you just use your thrust override like that, rather than pulsing your upward thruster on and off to save fuel? Well, you can do that automatically as well, using the new event controller block. So on the event controller, we can now detect grid speed. And you can make it so that once the speed reach a certain limit, then the upward thrusters just turn off. And then on another event controller, you can make it so that when the speed is slower than a certain limit, then the upward thrusters will just turn back on. And this basically automates the pulsing function of upward thrusters. And once we reach zero gravity, you can make it so that one of the event controllers turn off the event controller that turns on the thruster again once we go below a certain speed, so that it just won't keep turning on once we're in space. And this basically automates the whole orbiting process of ships. Alright, let's wait until it reach orbit here. Alright, we're at 0G now. Right, I forgot to put it on. There you go. The ship is no longer thrusting anymore. So, that's how the new event controller functions. Can automate getting your ship to orbit while saving fuel on space engineers.